How's it going, everyone? Thank you again for joining me here for the Schaefer's Stock Market Podcast. This is Josh Selway talking to you again, bringing you these quick podcasts every single week to keep you up to date on what's happening around the financial world. Thank you to everyone who's been listening every week. Our listenership goes up every single week, so I appreciate that. If you haven't already, subscribe, review wherever you are listening. And if you want to check out Schaefer's Investment Research, check us out on Twitter at Schaefer's or on Instagram, Facebook, StockTwits as well, or just go straight to schaefersresearch.com. Okay, so this week has been all about earnings reports. We're right in the middle of earnings season. This is one of the biggest weeks for earnings. So what I'm going to do to start out with, I'm going to go right down a list of some of the biggest names that you should be watching after earnings, some of the names that made the biggest moves, some of the most notable earnings releases that we came out with this week. So we'll start with the social media space, and Twitter, Facebook, and Snap all reported strong reports. Facebook, actually, that stock dipped after its earnings release, but that can be more attributed to all the regulatory issues surrounding Facebook at the moment, which there are a lot. The company paid a $5 billion fine to the U.S. government for its privacy concerns. A lot of talk about whether that was enough, but there's still going to be more ongoing regulatory issues surrounding Facebook going forward. This is far from the end of it. They promoted somebody to be their chief security officer or something along those lines, chief privacy officer. So they're still working to gain more trust on that front. But there's just more and more coming out. We have situations in Europe where they're trying to crack down on these tech companies. And we have Australia just today saying that it's going to try to actually look into Facebook and Google's algorithms to see how they could be affecting people in harmful ways. So that will be something to watch for these companies for sure. But Facebook's quarterly results were strong. They continued to print money hand over fist. Twitter, they posted strong quarterly sales as well. And they noted that they're putting more content that people actually want to see in front of users, which is leading to more ad dollars for the company. So that stock is spiking today as well. And Snapchat parent Snap, as we've said before, has been one of the biggest winners of 2019. It's more than tripled, and they just reported another strong quarter. That stock just took out its IPO price of $17, which could be significant and could mean that it could keep rallying. So the huge year for Snap stock continues. And in fact, Snap just keeps moving higher. I'm checking in on it today. This is Friday, a few days after the company's earnings release, and it's extending those gains, pushing past the $18 level, which was a previous level of resistance on the charts. So everything's looking good there for Snap as it continues to break out. Moving on from the social media sector, the next sector I wanted to look at was the restaurant space, which was the main focus of a recent podcast we did here. And essentially what we discussed then has continued in that these stocks have been exceptionally strong. The main winners, Chipotle, McDonald's, and Starbucks, all jumping after earnings, all posting strong quarters. Starting with Chipotle, their digital sales have almost doubled during the quarter. And Brian Niccol, the CEO there, saying that he sees this as just the beginning. There's more coming. Some analysts reiterated that sentiment. So Chipotle continues to just crush on all cylinders, it seems like. That stock has been one of the biggest S&P 500 winners of 2019. McDonald's, the Dow component, it is also at all-time highs. They just reported strong sales in North America. That is lifting that stock once again, another big winner from 2019. And of course, Starbucks is in the same exact boat, rallying to all-time highs. For, as I mentioned on the podcast where we talked about these stocks, Starbucks was range-bound in the $50 to $60 range for so long, and now it's nearing $100. So we're talking about almost a double in value for Starbucks. And really what investors are looking at for Starbucks is its China business and how its sales are doing over there. And right now, they're doing well. They're doing well in China and also in North America and for domestic sales in the U.S. Starbucks is really turned a corner here. The stock is just breaking out, and it's there's still a lot of negative sentiment around that stock. Of course, one of the things we always look at is analyst sentiment, and there's still room for analyst upgrades, price target hikes to come through, which could just bring more buyers to the table there for Starbucks and keep that stock's momentum going. And while we're talking about food, I should throw this in real quick. This wasn't on the earnings front, but Beyond Meat, ticker BYND, that stock is exploding again. It had a little turbulence there for a little bit after its initial takeoff after going public, where it just kept going higher. Well, it's doing that again. It just keeps going higher and higher. It's funny on finance Twitter that a lot of people come up with all these different metrics to just show how expensive the stock is. And it's pretty insane how the valuation for this stock, at least it would seem so, but who knows, because it just keeps going higher. People keep buying it. But Beyond Meat, last I saw it was, I can check here real quick, it was like at 240 or something. It's just 228 right now. So just more upside continuing for Beyond Meat. If you recall back, you know, around when it went public, it was back in May, it was around the $65 range, what I'm looking at here on the Google Finance chart. So just an outrageous start for Beyond Meat. And it was in focus this week because Dunkin' Brands, Dunkin' Donuts, is going to be using the Beyond Meat sausage in it in some of its stores. I believe it's starting in New York, and then we'll try to expand from there. And it was also interesting that Brian Niccol, the CEO of Chipotle, mentioned that the company would not be interested right now in using something like Beyond Meat's products because they're too processed and they do not meet Chipotle's standards. And this prompted a sharp comeback from Beyond Meat CEO, who said that, you know, their stuff's great, yada yada yada. So that was interesting to see that spat kind of come out of nowhere there. But Beyond Meat just continues to crush it. And the last sector I want to look at from earnings this week was the auto space, specifically starting with Ford, who gave a somewhat disappointing forecast. And when we checked in on that stock, it was on pace for its lowest or its worst day in over 3 years. So a huge pullback there in Ford's stock. It had been gaining some momentum there for a little bit, but this earnings release sparked some fear there among investors who began ditching the stock. And again, a huge sell-off there in Ford, just due to its forecast mainly. Tata Motors, the Indian car maker who makes Jaguar, that stock fell to fresh lows. It's been under a lot of pressure this year. Apparently, the car market in India, there's a lot of weakness around it, which has prompted many to worry about Tata Motors, which is ticker TTM. So that stock struggled as well. And then, of course, Tesla had this huge sell-off. Its earnings release was overall just a major disappointment, it would seem there. CEO Elon Musk said it may take longer than expected for the company to turn a profit. And Tesla shares are down another 2% today, trading around $223 per share. So, you know, it's like one step forward, two steps back for Tesla. Continues to bounce around the charts, but this earnings release was another step back for the company. Real quick, I wanted to point everyone's attention to a blog on our site about microchip technology, ticker MCHP. Every week, we recount some of our trades that we make in our trading services and show you how we really were approaching the trade and how we found success. And this one recounts how options traders, specifically call traders, were managed to triple their money in just 8 days. So if you want to check out how we approach options trades, every week we do one of these where we look back at a recent options trade, and the most recent one this week showed some pretty impressive profits there for call traders who listened to us and got that microchip technology option. It was a weekly call there that obviously made a huge profit in short time. So be on the lookout for those every single week. Okay, so the main topic I wanted to discuss here for a few minutes is virtual reality. And mainly what caught my attention this week was another article, this one on CNBC, about malls closing. This has been a huge story of 2019, is that there's been thousands of store closures. Many people call it the retail apocalypse, which is Could be pretty devastating for parts of the economy. Working in retail is the most common job in the U.S., so a lot of people are monitoring this. Of course, this goes hand in hand with the growth in Amazon, as well as brick and mortar stores struggle. But on top of the store closings, there's been many mall closings as well. And the big issue here is what to do with these malls, what to do with the real estate once the stores close up and those businesses leave, because there's such a glut on local communities and there's just these huge spaces that you would think you could use for some purpose. And, you know, one company that I saw was speculated could really benefit from this was Planet Fitness, as, you know, you reuse some of these spaces for workout centers and things of that nature. So Planet Fitness was one interesting play on this storyline. Another one that the CNBC article talked about was virtual reality spaces. And this is still a very young business, of course. Virtual reality is still in its infancy. But there's a few big players now, and the CNBC article I was looking at was talking about this company called The Void, which is creating these spaces, pop-up experiences, virtual reality experiences for people to play in, and it's pretty fascinating. So basically, this just gave me a reason to look into The Void, this company, and just see what they're all about. And as I said, it's still a very young company. Right now, they're only in 4 locations in the U.S., but they're working on expanding elsewhere up to 8 different locations. And they have a few different experiences, as they call them, virtual reality experiences. They partnered with Disney to do a Star Wars experience, which seems like it could be pretty cool. They have a Ralph Breaks VR experience, and they also partnered with Sony to do a Ghostbusters experience as well, which is interesting because Sony has, they provide virtual reality equipment and such with their PlayStation. So I don't know if they have any type of partnerships with that. I was trying to dig into the technology that The Void uses for its virtual reality to see if they use Facebook's Oculus. And it seemed like at the beginning they did do that. I'm not sure if they're still doing that, but there's a lot of different technology that goes into this. You have body suits and the technology on the ground and headphones, all this type of stuff that could we should pay attention to if you're someone that's looking to potentially invest in this space, because as this grows in popularity, obviously they'll need more and more of this technology. So it was hard to see what exactly they're using for these virtual reality experiences, but we'll probably get more clarity as these businesses keep growing. And aside from The Void, the other company I found that's also competing in this space right now, I'm sure there's some other ones, but there's this company, Sandbox VR, that was raising money as well. They only have a couple locations right now, so we'll keep an eye on these businesses as virtual reality continues to grow, and we'll see if these companies can take advantage of some of these store closings that we're seeing across the country, and if this could be a trend for how these retailers' real estate issues are solved by bringing in virtual reality companies. But I will point out, from a potential investor standpoint, a big part of virtual reality is this haptic technology, which essentially relates to touch and feel type things. Like right now, when people think of haptic technology, it's about, you know, if you on like the new iPhones, if you press down real hard, they'll vibrate, or they know they do certain commands based on how you move your finger and whatnot. That's where haptic technology is right now. But of course, going forward with virtual reality, that expands to all types of different things. You know, movement on your fingers if you're wearing certain gloves, and they'll need all types of different things. Movement on your feet. So there's a couple companies I wanted to just point out real quick. Stocks that are in this space. I'm not sure how much virtual reality exposure they have, but going forward, these are the types of companies that could play a small role in this type of business. And the first one is Immersion, that is ticker IMMR. That could be one company to watch. And then Synaptics is another one, that's ticker SYNA. So those are just two stocks that could have technology that is used in this space and could give you some opportunity to invest in VR. And of course, you could also just consider Facebook, who has the Oculus headset and other technology around this. And as I said, PlayStation does its own thing. Sony's PlayStation does. And Google is moving in as well. So just got to keep tabs on what these virtual reality experiences are using and what companies they're partnering with to see how you can get the best exposure to this growing business. But I'm going to leave it right there for this episode, you guys. Thank you all for listening again. We'll be back next week with another episode. Again, if you want to check us out, go over to schafersresearch.com. We have blogs coming out all throughout the day to keep you up to date on what's happening in the stock market and financial world. We have free newsletters you can sign up for the morning, evening. Whenever you want your business news, you can check those out over on the website as well and sign up for free. Get those delivered straight to your inbox. But until next time, this is Josh Selway. Thank you so much for listening. Talk to you soon.